Welcome students, we are going to start today's topic. That today's topic is matrices. All you have known about the matrices in your previous classes. Now we are going to discuss the matrices once again in some extended manners. As you know, the matrices are everywhere. If you have used a spreadsheet such as Excel or written a table, you have used a matrix. Matrices makes presentation of numbers clear and make calculation easier to program. Now if we discuss a matrix given in the slide, there are three rows and four columns. The columns are mentioned as Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. These are the four quarters in a year. And there are some tires types, tire stone, Michigan, copper. If we want to know about how many copper tires were sold in the quarter four of any particular year, then we have to move in the copper row through the quarter four. Then we get an element 27. So therefore we can say that in quarter four, the total copper tires sold were 27. Now, if we come across the definition of matrix, a matrix is a rectangular array of elements arranged in row and columns enclosed within the brackets. The elements can be symbolic expressions or numbers. The matrix always denoted by a capital letters. If we see the given matrix, there are elements A11, A12, A1n. These are the elements of first row. A21, A22, up to so on, A2n. These are the elements of second row. Likewise, we can say that AM1, AM2, AMn. These are the elements of mth rows. So we can say the elements of ith row having elements are AI1, AI2, AIN. Similarly, the column J of the matrix having M elements can be written as AIJ, A2J, up to so on, AMJ. So therefore, in the row we have N elements and in the columns we have M elements. So every matrix has rows and columns, and this defines the size of the matrix. Size means the number of elements in the matrix. If a matrix has m rows and n columns, the size of the matrix is denoted by m cross n or simply m into n. The matrix A can also be written in this format like A into m cross n to show that matrix A has m rows and n columns. Each entry of the matrix is called the element of the matrix, and it is denoted by Aij, where I is denotes the number of row and J denotes the number of column of the element. If we discuss the previous example of tires, we find the element 27, which lies in the third row and fourth column. Therefore, the element A34 will be 27, and the size of the matrix will be 3 cross 4, and the total number of elements will be 3 into 4, which is equals to 12. Now we will discuss the type of matrices. First is row matrix. If any matrix having only one row or any number of columns, it will be called a row matrix. For example, if we have a matrix like B1, B2 up to Bn, the matrix is having one row and n number of columns, this matrix will be called as row matrix. Column matrix, if a matrix has only one column and any number of row, it will be called a column matrix. For example, we are having a matrix C. In this matrix, we have elements C1, C2, up to Cm. So we can say that we are having one column and m number of rows. This is the column matrix. We are having two examples. One is for row matrix and other is for column matrix. If we see the matrix B, this matrix having one row and five columns. Therefore, this is a row matrix whose dimension is 5. In the second example, we have a matrix C, which contains one column and three rows. Therefore, this is a column matrix of dimension 3. Now we discuss about the sum matrix. If from any matrix we reduce some rows or some columns, then the remaining matrix can be called a sum matrix. Or we can not delete any row or any column. The matrix will also can be called a submatrix. As the example is given, a matrix A is given. So if we split this matrix into other matrices, the each matrix will called a submatrix of the matrix A. Now come to the square matrix. In any matrix, if the number of rows is same as the number of columns, then the matrix is called a square matrix. For example, we have a matrix A in which there are three rows and three columns. Hence, the given matrix is a square matrix. Also, the entries A11, A22, up to so on, ANN are called the diagonal elements of the square matrix. The diagonal matrix is also called the principal diagonal or the main diagonal. For this matrix, we have the diagonal elements as 25, 10, 7. These are elements are called the elements of principal diagonal. Now come to the triangular matrix. In triangular matrix, we have two matrices, upper triangular matrix and lower triangular matrix. First, we discuss about upper triangular matrix. A m cross n matrix is called an upper triangular matrix if all the elements below the principal diagonal are zero. For example, if we discuss the given matrix A, the diagonal elements are 10, minus 1, 5, and below this diagonal, the elements are zero. Each elements are zero. So therefore, this type of matrix can be called an upper triangular matrix. Similarly, lower triangular matrix, a m cross n matrix is called a lower triangular matrix if all the elements above the principal diagonals are zero. For example, if we consider a matrix A having three rows and three columns, the elements on the principal diagonal are 1, 1 and 1. If we see, we can see the elements above the principal diagonal are zero. So this type of matrix can be called as lower triangular matrix. Now come to the diagonal matrix. If a square matrix with all non-diagonal elements equal to zero. Non-diagonal elements means the elements which are not lie on the principal diagonal. Therefore, if a matrix in which all the non-diagonal elements equal to zero is called a diagonal matrix, that is, only the diagonal elements can be non-zero. Also, all the diagonal elements of a diagonal matrix can be zero. We have an example in front of us. Similarly, identity matrix. A diagonal matrix with all diagonal elements equal to 1 is called an identity matrix. Mathematically, if we can say, in identity matrix, Aii should be equals to I, sorry, should Aii should be equals to 1 for all the values of I, and Aij should be equals to 0 for when I is not equals to j. There are two examples of identity matrix. One identity matrix having 4 rows and 4 columns. This is the identity matrix of order 4. Other is having 3 rows and 3 columns. Therefore, this is an identity matrix of order 3. Now come to the zero matrix or null matrix. As name suggests, Any matrix having all its entries zero is called a null matrix or zero matrix. Two examples are given below. One matrix is A, having three rows and three columns. All the elements are zero. Therefore, this is a null matrix. Other is matrix B, in which there are two rows and three columns. This is also a null matrix, having all the elements zero. Now come to the trigonal matrix. A tri-diagonal matrix has non-zero elements only on the main diagonal, the diagonal upon the main diagonal, and the diagonal below the main diagonal. This special structure appears often in scientific computing and computer graphics. We have one example of tri-diagonal matrix. Let's say we can see the elements of the principal diagonal are 1, 4, 3, 3, and the elements on the diagonal above the principal diagonal are 4, 1, 4. These elements are 0. Similarly, the elements below the principal diagonal 3, 2, 1, and these elements are also 0. So this type of structure can be called as tri-diagonal matrix. Now we come to the diagonally dominant matrix. A n cross n matrix is called diagonally dominant if the absolute value of the diagonal element is greater than or equal to the sum of the absolute values of the rest of the elements of that row, and that the inequality is strictly greater than for at least one row. The diagonally dominant matrices plays an important role in ensuring convergence in iterative schemes of solving simultaneous linear equation. We have one example. We have a matrix, square matrix, having three rows and three columns. If we check first row, the diagonal element is 15, which is greater than the absolute values of the other elements 6 and 7. For the second row, the diagonal element is minus 4. The absolute value of this element is 4, which is again greater than or equal to the sum of the absolute values of the rest of the elements. Similarly, for the third row, the diagonal elements is 6, which is greater than the rest of the elements. Now we have checked that at least one row, that is row 1 and 3 in this case, the inequality is strictly greater than. Hence, the given matrix is a diagonally dominant matrix. Now discuss another example. In this matrix, we have the first diagonal element is minus 15. The absolute value of this element is 15, and which is equal to the sum of the absolute values of the rest of the elements. Now the second element is minus 4. The absolute values of this is 4, which is again equal to the sum of the absolute value of other elements. If we check the last element, the 3-3 element, which is greater than the sum of the absolute value of the rest of the element. So in this case, we also check that the given matrix is again a diagonally dominant matrix. Now come to the third example. In this matrix, if we check the second row, the element 8, the 2-2 element, and its absolute value is less than the summation of the absolute value of the rest of the element. So in this case, the matrix is not the diagonally dominant matrix. Now come to the transpose of a matrix. If in a given matrix we interchange the rows and the corresponding columns, the new matrix obtained is called the transpose of the matrix A, and it is denoted by AT or A dash. So we have an example. We have a square matrix of order 3, and if we interchange the rows to the columns, the first row can be converted to the first column, second row is interchanged with the second column, third row is interchanged with the third column. So in this process, the new matrix is called the transpose of the previous matrix. Now come to the symmetric matrix. A square matrix can be called a symmetric matrix if for all values of Ai and j, Aij is same as Aji. That is, if the matrix is same as its transpose, then the matrix is called a symmetric matrix. We have an example. One can see that if we take the transpose of this matrix, we can obtain the matrix A again. So this is a symmetric matrix. Another matrix is skew symmetric matrix. A square matrix will be called a skew symmetric matrix if for all values of I and j, Aij is equals to the minus of Aji. That is, if the transpose of a matrix is equal to the negative of the matrix, then the matrix is called the skew symmetric matrix. And one more condition, a matrix to be skew symmetric, that all the diagonal elements of the given matrix must be equal to zero. We have one example in front of us. Now discuss about the orthogonal matrix. A square matrix A is called an orthogonal matrix if the product of the matrix A and its transpose matrix A dash is an identity matrix. For example, if we multiply a matrix with its transpose and we get an identity matrix, then the matrix is called an orthogonal matrix. Now come to the conjugate matrix. The conjugate matrix of any matrix can be obtained by making the conjugate of each of the elements of the given matrix. The conjugate matrix is denoted by A bar. Let's see one example. A matrix A is given having two rows and three columns, and if we take the complex conjugate of each of the elements, we obtain a new matrix like 1 minus I, 2 minus 3i, 4, 7 minus 2i, I, 3 plus 2i. So this is the matrix obtained by making the complex conjugate of the previous matrix. This is called the conjugate matrix of A, and it is denoted by A bar. Now we come to the matrix A theta. If we take the transpose of the conjugate matrix, the new matrix obtained is called the transpose conjugate matrix, which is denoted by A theta. If we have a matrix A having two rows and three columns, and the transpose of the matrix, as we have discussed earlier, we have converted the matrix A to its transpose conjugate matrix, and in the next step we took the transpose of the matrix A bar, so we can obtain the matrix A theta by taking the transpose of the previous matrix. Now we can discuss the unitary matrix. A square matrix A is called an unitary matrix if A theta multiplied by A is an identity matrix. We have one example with us. The matrix A is given as follows. We converted the matrix A theta, and if we multiplied by A theta to A, we can get the matrix I. This is like an homework with all you students. You check whether we can get the matrix I by multiplying A theta into A. If we get the multiplication equals to identity matrix, then we can say the given matrix is an unitary matrix. Now discuss about the Hermitian matrix. A square matrix A is called Hermitian matrix if every ijth element of A is equal to conjugate complex jith element of A. In mathematical terms, if aij is equals to aji bar, that means the conjugate of ji element. We have one example. We can check that this can be a Hermitian matrix. The necessary and sufficient condition for a matrix A to be Hermitian is that the matrix should be equals to its A theta matrix. Skew Hermitian matrix. A square matrix A is called skew Hermitian matrix if every ijth element of A is equal to negative conjugate complex of jith element of A. In other words, aij is equals to the minus of aji bar. So we have one example once again. So we can check through this matrix that this is an a skew Hermitian matrix. This part is left for the student to verify whether the given matrix is skew Hermitian or not. Now we have the necessary condition. The necessary and sufficient condition for a matrix A to be skew Hermitian is that if the matrix A theta is equal to the minus of the given matrix, then the matrix is called the skew Hermitian matrix. Other condition is this: all the diagonal element of a skew Hermitian matrix should either be zero or pure imaginary. Now come to the idempotent matrix. A matrix A is said to be idempotent if the square of the matrix is equal to that matrix, that is A square equals to A. We have one example. So the matrix A is given and we calculated the square of the matrix, which is again equal to the given matrix. So in this way we can say that the given matrix is a idempotent matrix. Now come to the periodic matrix. A matrix A will be called a periodic matrix if A to the power k plus 1 is equals to A, where k is a positive integer. If k is the least positive integer such that k plus 1 equals to A, then k is said to be period of matrix A. So if we choose k equals to 1, we get A square equals to A and we call it to be idempotent. Now come to the nilpotent matrix. A matrix A will be called a nilpotent matrix if A to the power k equals to 0, that is null matrix, where k is a positive integer. If k is the least positive integer such that A to the power k equals to 0, then k is the index of the nilpotent. We have one example with us. The matrix A is given and we calculated the square of the matrix, which is equals to the null matrix. So we can say the matrix A is nilpotent having index 2. Involuntary matrix. A matrix A will be called an involuntary matrix if A square equals to I. I means identity matrix. And we know that I square is equals to I always. Therefore, unit matrix is always an involuntary matrix. Now we discuss about the square matrix. If the determinant of the matrix is zero, then the matrix is known as a singular matrix. Equal matrix. Two matrices are said to be equal if they follow the given two conditions. Both the matrix should be of the same order and the element in the corresponding position should be equal. If we discuss about the given two matrices A and B, we can check the order of the two matrices are equal and the all the elements are equal. In this way we can say the matrix A and B are equal. We have one question. The two matrices are given which are equal and we have to find the values of x, y, z and A which satisfy the matrix equation. So this is a given equation. If we see that the order of the both the matrix are same, both of the 2 cross 2 having 2 rows and 2 columns. So, and it is given that the both the matrices are equal. So we can say that x plus 3 equals to 0, 2y plus x equals to minus 7, z minus 1 equals to 3, 4a minus x equals to 2a. So if we use the condition of equal matrices, we can say that this condition we can find four equations. On solving these four equations, we can get the values of x, y, z and a. X will be minus 3, y is minus 2, z is 4 and a is 3. So this is all for today. We will discuss some other topics regarding matrices in our next lecture. Thank you.